Hey Scorpio friends, so this is Christelle Martinette and I'm reading for you for the month of January. I have here the initiatory tarot of the Golden Dawn, and I also have my Vida Sibila course. I have my Vida Sibila cards, and I'll talk about the course in a second. And the runes to cast, crowning the reading in the end. Do visit my website, www.christellemartinette, that's one word, .com. And you'll see on the main menu, as you shift from home to the right, there's an energy menu. And there you'll find anything from white magic to Reiki to soul therapy to clearing. There's a clearing house in there. and then go to the main menu again, and you'll see, if you shift over a bit, hypnotherapy. There I offer past life regression sessions and neuro-linguistic programming sessions as well. Then if you move over, I have my cartomancy menu, where you'll find readings, card readings, and sessions, mediumship, channeling, and scrying sessions there as well. And lo and behold, then I'll have my Vida Sibila. You'll see La Vida Sibila. The course is What Would Life Be Without Them. It's a certification course, and you can purchase that in individual models, two at a time, or an entire course. Let's get on with the reading to see what January holds for you and what the cards want to say. How lovely to get the first card out is the Fool. Just lovely. Let me show you these cards. The Fool, the Tower, the Moon, the Two of Wands, the Five of Wands, the Eight of Wands. Three wands all across, right from the, right, zoom. Four of Pentacles. Wow, there's some interesting. There's this Knight of Swords, this Knight of Swords energy here. And the Eight of Cups. A little bit of indecision and uncertainty with that Eight of Cups. Now, let me take a look. There's these beautiful three, and I still do think the Tower is a beautiful card, because there is the beginning of an energy that is the beginning, right in the beginning of January. It is a wonderful, a lively beginning. But it is a beginning that has a cost. It comes with a price tag. It comes with the realization that nothing has worked so far. I have been unsuccessful. I spend my time on the area of the side where the moon hides things. The moon has a side that is the dark side. Now, there's the world of gray, and I'm reminded of the saying, if you see everything gray, if all you see is gray, move that elephant, and that's what the cards seem to say. Move the elephant, Scorpio. Of course, these passion cards here, the Two, the Five, and the Eight, what can I say? If you can think the Two, I do language analyses, and this is the way I conduct my readings. I look first of all to things that are missing. And what's missing here? 2, 5, 7. The 3 and the 4 is missing, and the 6 and the 7 is missing. Now, I ask myself, well, why is that? The 4 and the 5 talk about firm foundation and security and change. Security and change, they're not there. There's antagonism. There's the 5 that talk about change. Once again, the 2, the 3 and the 4, sorry, the 3 and the 4, the 3 of Wands is a bond, the 4 of Wands is security, they're not there. We have the 5, which talk of change. And the 6 and the 7, the 6 is a victory and the 7 is a burden. They're not there. The seven is a burden when you face responsibilities. They're not there. But we have this eight of wands. And it's as if, Scorpio, you make a leap, hop, and a jump, and you put yourself in a situation of extreme. You go to the person. You haven't talked to that person forever. And you say, all right, what are we going to do? Is it now? It's now or never. And the person sits there, their jaw is down, and thinking, what is this person saying? What is he or she saying to me? Complete, under the tower, I have the four of pentacles, which is the phoenix arising from its ashes and taking the liberty of not having, being unbridled. You come in with an unbridled energy, and then all of a sudden, stop and think, what am I doing? Is it worth it? And this is you, Scorpio, the month of January. Let me take the Sibylla cards to see how correct I am. Okay, first of all, let me take the Tower and see what the Tower has to say. And I've got here, let me show you. I've got the Child, Bambino, Malinconia, Melancholy, and Suspiri. The beginning of something that is, what? Is it beginning or not? Should we start or not? Should the beginning is seemingly so slow that it's almost making you think, is it beginning or not? But there's also that idea of that saving you, really, it's the saving grace, that there is underlying in your heart of hearts, you know that there's something there. You know that there's something there. But the Tower talks about an incident, a moment, a realization that things need to be burned to the ground. Things have to tumble to the ground in order for them to start up again. Now, the moon. Let me take a look at the moon. You know, move the elephant. If you're seeing gray, move that elephant, Scorpio. All you see is gray. Move the elephant. Okay. We've got the Superbia, vanity, which is also success, however. Gelosia, jealousy, and il nemico, the enemy. I'm seeing this as you being your own enemy here. And also you in a position of constantly, I'm going to say it, please don't, I know I get all of these thumbs down, but Scorpio, please let me say it. That green-eyed monster is yours. They should have, instead of calling it a green-eyed monster, they would have called the Scorpio monster. The jealousy is there. It's we all are jealous. We are, it's part of human nature, we are. But what ultimately spurs you on and really gets you to hold on to what you really truly desire is that jealousy and is the threat of someone else coming to take your loved one away. And that really gets your gumption up and really makes you emboldened and impassioned at the same time. Move the elephant, Scorpio. Move that elephant. One last card, this Eight of Cups at the bottom. I want to see what that is all about. Well, what are we doing here with the Eight of Cups? We've got fidelity, gran consolazione. I'm going to say that again, gran consolazione. La 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 la. Success, success, success. Somebody likes you up there, Scorpio. Lettera, communication, finally comes out. And it is, you know, there's a lot of things going on with you, Scorpio, the month of January. It's, you're going to go through four different seasons in your heart and in your emotions, emotional roller coaster. Let me see what the runes have to say. Yes, yes, if you can. You feel as though you are, you're treading in murky waters, something that is new, you're scared. There's also there, however, you're with on a tightrope without a net. This is how you feel the month of January. However, the runes are telling you, give yourself time. Give yourself time. Go forward. Over this Eight of Wands, I have AWATS. Go forward. That is going to be the measure of your success. That will be the key to your success. Also, that elephant there, what is the elephant hiding? The elephant hiding is hiding a life together with someone who you could have never imagined possible. Again, go forward with Rido. Go forward. Gifu, right in the middle. You have to know, Scorpio, that the measure of success has to do with the give and take. And it's through the give and take that you will receive. I hope this was of help to you, Scorpio. Namaste. Until we meet together again, do have a great New Year's. Bye-bye.